So Fitbit's been around for a few years now, and it's trying to convince you that you need to track everything you do throughout your day. First of all, it had clip-ons, then little activity wristbands, and now it's graduating to smartwatches. Last year's Ioniq was a little bit much for some people, so now they've come back with what they call the Fitbit Versa, a £200 smartwatch that tracks what you do. So this is the Fitbit Versa, and it's quite a radical design change from the Fitbit Ioniq that came out last year. If the Ioniq was fairly bulky and large, then this Versa is more subtle and sleek. It replaces the older Fitbit Blaze in the company's lineup. This is a watch designed for both men and women, despite the fact that the Versa totes the ability to help users track their menstrual cycle. This full feature is rolling out in an update that will also include Android Quick Replies. If you're on iOS, you'll have to wait. Also though, the Versa and Fitbit app still work on Windows Phone. This is perhaps a more feminine looking watch in general, but there's also a silver and grey, rose gold and black version to help you decide. It's a big design change from the Ioniq, with a pebble-like design, and we're talking about the brand Pebble here, the one that Fitbit acquired before this watch was made. Fitbit has updated the software for the Versa, and it's slicker and more useful now. There are nicer watch faces, the menus remain clean and simple, and there are a few extra features like Starbucks and Deezer integration, the latter preferable to the US-only Pandora support from before. Swiping up on the Versa gets you to the Today view without having to look at the app, which was a drawback before. You get a clear overview of your activities throughout the day, but you will have to reach for the app if you want to look further back than that. It's a watch aimed at a wide range of people, from the casual walker to the more devoted runner, cyclist, swimmer, or serious gym goer. It's not just focused on fitness, but on other gentler but no less important aspects of our overall health too, from calmness and sleep to more detailed female health tracking features. There are many exercise routines to choose from, including swim tracking, thanks to full waterproofing. However, do remember that in comparison to the Ioniq, the Versa doesn't have built-in GPS, and that's partly why it's £100 cheaper. But if you do want to record that run and where you've gone on the Versa, you'll have to take your phone with you. The Fitbit app is still very good though, and it's where you'll have to go for certain information like your sleep patterns or a friend's activity, or to download new watch faces or add music to the watch that you can stream, without your phone, to wireless headphones. Fitbit has better integrated the wallet app too, but in the UK, the only major bank supported is Santander. It's good that the Versa includes a small or large strap in the box too, so you'll be sure of a good fit, and the straps are easy enough to clip on and off. But it still doesn't do many smartwatch things, and notifications are still poor and only just becoming actionable, and the interface for these is not as slick as Apple Watch or even Wear OS. The App Store is anemic, and the Versa simply isn't a very good smartwatch, even if it's great at all the Fitbit things.
So if you're looking to buy a Fitbit and you think there are too many, you'd be right. There are way too many Fitbits out there. But Fitbit hopes that the Versa is a more well-rounded smartwatch than last year's Ioniq. And at £199 in the UK, you might be more tempted to look at it. It's good if you want to track your steps, heart rate, sleep patterns, and GPS as long as you take your phone. And it might be a little bit more palatable, given it's slightly more stylish and a bit more subtle. We think it's a good Fitbit, but it's not an excellent smartwatch.